Have you heard about this crazy virus going around called the quarantine virus or something?
Oh yeah, I've heard something about that. My mom keeps making me wash my hands and cough my elbow like this, which is kind of annoying. All my favorite stuff is getting canceled, and I'm supposed to just stay home. I don't get what it's all about, and I'm feeling worried.
Yeah, I can't be scary when we don't understand something. And this virus is a big deal. It's making us change a lot of things about our day. But I was reading in the Bible that God says we don't need to be afraid. He wants to give us a spirit of power, love, and self-control.
So you're telling me that God can make me brave and he's in control even when there is a virus?
Oh yes, Psalm 91 says that God is ready to be a hiding place for anyone who wants to trust him. It says he wants to gather us all up under his wing like a mama bird to keep us safe.
That sounds amazing. So do I still need to wash my hands and cover my cough and skip on chess club like the grown-ups say?
Oh yes. Remember how we've been learning that God wants us to love our neighbors? Loving our neighbors right now means we take care of them by washing our hands, covering our coughs. But it also means we can pray for them to know how much God loves them. God says we don't need to be afraid about anything because he is big enough and strong enough to care for it all.
Good morning, Imago Dei kids. My name is Petra, and I'm giving announcements for us today.
Announcements!
Last week we heard about how much God cares about birds and how he cares about for you even more. This week we will hear how Jesus does impossible things. Before we sing more songs and hear more about Jesus' kingdom, let's celebrate the people who had birthdays this week. If you have a birthday coming up soon, we would like to give you this blessing. Everyone say this with me as we remind these people how special they are to all of us. God made you.
God made you.
God knows you.
God knows you.
God loves you.
God loves you.
We are also praying for kids in Tanzania to have food. Repeat after me this blessing for kids in Tanzania. God made kids in Tanzania.
God made kids in Tanzania.
God knows kids in Tanzania.
God knows kids in Tanzania.
God loves kids in Tanzania.
God loves kids in Tanzania.
All right, kids, come over.
Yay, bubbles!
Welcome, kids. I'm so excited to see you. And we started with some bubbles. We're talking about a story about Jesus calming the storm today. But first, let's practice our memory verse. It is love.
Turn
the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. We're going to add that in. And this is the greatest commandment, is also to love your neighbor as yourself. Good job. Let's sing.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
And we're going to be talking about a story where Jesus does amazing, impossible things because we remember that our God is so mighty, right? We say,
what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve.
Good job. Let's get into this story. All right, we're going to read our story in the Bible today. All day long, Jesus taught big crowds of people about God. Jesus was very tired. So when evening came, he said to his disciples, "Let's go in our boat to the other side of the lake." And while they were sailing, Jesus fell asleep. Can you pretend to fall asleep? Some of his disciples were fishermen, and they knew everything about sailing and steering a boat. Surely they didn't need Jesus to get the boat across the lake. But then a huge thunderstorm came. Thunder, boom, and lightning, flash. A big wind came whistling and howling and racing across the water right at them. By this time, they were in the middle of the lake, and there was nothing they could do. The small boat rocked from side to side, and as it rocked, water poured in. "We're going to sink," cried one of the men. Even the fishermen, who knew all about sailing, were terrified. "Wake up, Jesus," they shouted, "save us." Jesus stood up and he said to the wind, "Stop," and it stopped. "Why are you so afraid?" he asked his disciples. "Don't you have any faith?" "Who is this?" the disciples whispered to each other. "Even the wind obeys him." Wow. Jesus is God's son, and he is greater than the wind and the waves and our biggest fears. All right, so here is the sample of an activity that you can do at home. We made storm jars. Whoa, and this guy, he's doing okay. He's kind of floating in there. But you just dye some water blue and put oil on the top, and you can even, you want to shake it up really, really good. Shake it, shake it, shake it. Good job. All right, now let's play a game. Are you guys ready? Let's go play. All right, let's reenact the story that we just did. So we're gonna make our blanket, our boat, and we got our disciples, and who's gonna be Jesus?
Me.
All right, we can all take turns being Jesus.
Okay.
So you're really tired, you're gonna fall asleep. And then, oh no, the storm! Wake up, Jesus! Did you say stop?
Yes.
And the storm stopped. All right. Do you, who wants to be Jesus next?
Me.
Okay.
Can I be Jesus next?
Fall asleep. Oh no, it's the storm.
Wake up. Stop.
Good job. All right,
Jesus.
One more.
And I'll shake this.
One more storm. Do you want to be Jesus?
No.
No, that's okay. All right, that's how you're gonna do it?
Yeah.
All right. Fall asleep. So tired. Talking to all the big crowds.
Wake up! Wake up! Stop!
Nice job.